onto shoulder cars. And with the shoulder, again, we want to make sure everything is nice and still, and we're isolating that movement through that shoulder joint. I like to create a fist in my hand to create a little bit of tension through the arm, and that allows, again, me to focus on moving through the shoulder and not the elbow or the wrist. I also like to put my other hand on my rib cage to give me some cues to if I'm rotating or compensating through my body. So I'm going to keep nice and still there and in a ribs down position. So I'm going to start with my thumb pointing back towards the back wall and lift my arm as far as I can go without starting to elevate my shoulder towards my ear. Once I can't go any further, I'm going to rotate that thumb back again and continue through the range, and you should feel a nice stretch through the front of the chest there. Once I get here, I'm going to rotate my thumb back towards the back wall and repeat. I'm going to go 3 times in this direction, and then I'm going to switch how I rotate. So now I'm going to start with my thumb facing forward. I'm going to go as far as I can. Once I can't go any further, I'm going to rotate that thumb down and continue onto the range. That one will feel a little bit different. It'll feel less like a stretch across the chest and more isolated to the joint. Good. We can also do these in the opposite direction. Again, making sure that I'm not cheating by rotating my body to get the range. Good. And we'll switch sides. If you're having trouble maintaining tension through the arm, sometimes it can be helpful to grip something in your hand, like a tennis ball or a lacrosse ball, or even a small towel. So that's 3. Now we'll switch ways, so thumb back, up as far as you can, and then rotate back. Again, sometimes we can get a little bit of discomfort in end range. So if you get a little bit of pinching, just back off and keep going, but in a smaller circle. So again, with cars, we want to reverse directions. And we want to try and get as big of a circle as possible without compensation. So the goal here is not to do what you can to get the range, it's staying in a comfortable, controllable range of motion for each joint.